welcome to another special edition of Shelby This Week. 2018 is here, and there are many exciting new things happening for Shelby Township and Macomb County. In this show, we will look into what 2017 brought us and what we'll find out about new ventures we can expect as we move forward into 2018. Arthur Schenk has the exclusive interviews with our local officials. Arthur?
I'm here with Police Chief Robert Shelide with the Shelby Township Police Department. Thanks for coming in. A lot of things happened here in Shelby Township with the police department in 2017. Chief, tell me a little bit about what happened and some of the kind of the milestones.
Well, the big thing that happened is we were able to convince the Board of Trustees that we need some more space at the police department. And we're working with closely with the architects right now. We're going to add about 7,000 square feet. The police department is currently 17,000 square feet. I know some of the taxpayers and residents would be worried. The police department is 5 years old. Well, let me give you a comparison. The Clinton Township Police Department is about 100 staff of 100, and there's 68,000 square feet, and the building was built in this century in the last 15 years. We're 17,000 square feet, and I have 91 on my staff. So we're very small. We're kind of bursting at the seams. So this all started where my fleet coordinator, Ron Mix, I was going to a meeting for the court with Mr. Stathicus and the township engineers, and my fleet coordinator told me, his chief, you know, one day we need some more space. And then that conversation with Ron led to me talking to the supervisor and then him talking to other board members, and then here we are, and we're going to start breaking ground hopefully in the spring.
Okay, breaking ground in the spring. How do you think it's going to better the community once it's kind of finished?
Well, it's going to, first of all, we're the 26th safest city in the United States, mm-hmm. our community, which is an incredible accomplishment. Our police department needs more space. They need different areas to meet with the different teams we have. We've established, over my leadership over the last 3 years, we've established a traffic unit. We've established a tactical response unit. They have nowhere to meet these units. They come in for their briefings. So the bottom line is we're going to get a little bit more space for these guys to meet. We're expanding to the point we're going to have a modern conference room. Right now, if anybody's been over to my building, you come to my conference room and the walls are all scraped because there's no room. People push your chair back against the wall. It's like literally a shoebox. So we're going to have a conference room where people actually can come and meet and have a space. It's going to hold 24 people in the room, and I'm very excited about it. It'll be the showpiece of the new building.
One of your officers, Officer Leslie, kind of wears a lot of hats for you. I know she does some of your media for your department. But also she helped orchestrate the new police trailer.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about that, and then what are your plans in the upcoming year and how to kind of use that?
Well, this is all her doing. She's a very talented officer that we have. She is a jack of all trades. She decided that she was going to build this educational trailer, and it's the educational portion is for parents to learn about how kids are basically getting around their parents by using drugs, hiding the marijuana in their house or whatever drugs they're using. So what she's done is she's created an actual kid's bedroom inside of this educational trailer. And she has all the different compartments where kids hide their drugs. So she's able to take parents into the trailer and show them this is what you're supposed to be looking for. So I was actually amazed. She got all private funding lined up for it. And she does a fantastic job for us, something I'm very proud of. So our police department has written up an award for her Governor's Traffic Safety Award. So we had Sergeant Walsh do it, and we're hoping that Leslie's going to get the award. I think the award ceremony is sometime in March, so we're waiting to hear from the governor's office if she gets the award or not.
Now, one of the awkward things with that is a lot of parents are worried about invading their child's privacy, but this comes down to the life of your child, maybe.
Of course. I mean, I know a lot of people say that, and I don't want to be condescending, but that's ridiculous. We have to protect our children. It's already been established that the human brain, especially with boys, their brain is not developed until they're 25 years old. And if you're under mom and dad's roof, I don't care how old you are, they're in charge. And you're going to abide by mom and dad's rules. And if my police department and my officers can ever help in any way, help the parents in a situation like that where parents aren't listening, I encourage them, call the police. We'll come right over and have a conversation with the child.
Well, beautiful. That look to the future. Let's move on to 2018. What does the department have coming up here that we might be on the lookout for?
Well, something I'm very excited about. We just got board approval 2 board meetings ago to hire 6 new officers. It's going to bring our staffing up to 71 officers. Now, our population right now is right at 78,000 people. I eventually want to get the police department to have 1 officer for every 1,000 residents. That's the standard set by the Southeast Michigan Council on Governments. And this is an affluent community, okay? You see the building going on. Someone told me a stat the other day that we've had over $1 billion worth of new construction in the last 3 years alone, 15, 16, 17. So the people that are putting this kind of money into our township, they expect when they call the police for them to be there, be on time, be professional, and give great service. Well, to do that, we have to have the staff that has enough numbers to be there appropriately, okay? And my numbers have been down a little bit. And the Board of Trustees, working very closely with them, have agreed to beef the staff up a little bit, so we're going to 71 officers. And then specifically, the six people that we're hiring, all talented young people, I'm very excited to get them in the door.
Chief, I know you have some new recruits that you're kind of eyeballing, because in today's market, if you will, it's kind of hard for departments to find good people.
Correct.
I guess you already have some people in mind?
Well, we've already hired the six people. We've given them conditional offers of employment.
Okay.
Right now they're doing their drug screen, their physical, and their psychological testing. We plan on hiring them on January 5th. It was going to be their first day. The swearing-in ceremony is at 2 o'clock. But another program that I'm excited to tell you about is a cadet program that we're starting up. I've already met with the Board of Trustees. We've worked closely with the union on this. So we're going to be able to bring young kids that have a couple years of college in already, that know they want to be police officers, bring them on the staff, and we're going to give them assignments. They're going to ride along with our officers. They're going to process prisoners, do fingerprints, take photos of prisoners, et cetera, work up on our front desk. And what's going to do is we're going to be able to take a look at them and decide if we want to hire this person as a police officer or not. And it's going to help streamline to the point where if you are talented, you live in the area, and you want to work at our police department, you can come in the door, we'll get you in the door, take a look at you, and if we want to hire you, we'll send you to the police academy. So not a lot of departments are doing that. I'm very excited about getting this program underway.
Beautiful. Well, it sounds like a lot of great things going on in the upcoming year for the police department. We wish you well, and we thank you for your diligence. I'm sure the citizens do as well.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
for having me.
Thank you. Now up on our look ahead to 2018 is Shelby Township Fire Chief Jim Swinkowski. Jim, thanks for being here. Tell me a little bit about what happened in 2017 to your department and how it may affect the township.
Well, 2017 was obviously a big year for us. We built Station 5 and opened it over at 21 in Channer area, bringing a first response service to that area for the first time. And we hired six employees. We added six employees to the department between the latter half of 2016 and the first half of 2017 to get ready for this. And just making the changes with the equipment, building the station, bringing some additional resources down to that area so we can get to that area quicker. Because that 4 or 5 square miles down in the southeast has been the busiest part of the township for a long, long time, just because of the way the population density and the way the development had occurred. So that was probably the biggest task that we had going in 2017.
Tell me a little bit about how that station benefited the community. From what I understand, it was kind of an immediate impact.
Oh, it definitely was. If you look back, if you look at our map, M53 kind of divides the eastern 12 and a half square miles from the rest of the township with just the major overpasses as an avenue to get over there. But that 12 and a half square miles had only been serviced by one station, and with approximately 40% to 42% of all of our runs occurring east of the freeway, getting the additional resources from our headquarters at 23 Mount and then our western stations over there, it takes time. And with the traffic and the congestions, it was just difficult to get resources down there. When Station 4, that's on Shaner north of 23, would be busy, they'd be out, and we were always trying to get additional resources down there, so it took a lot of time. And by building that station, opening it, boom, we have the additional resources, we have additional manpower east of M53, both north and south, and now we have a greater impact on the services for the residents.
Okay, you mentioned Station 4 earlier. What are the plans now? What are you going to do with Station 4?
Well, moving forward toward into 2018, as we get through this year, we will be getting construction and get that station open, sometime in the latter part of the year. And we are going to now move that station north to around 25 and Shaner to try and balance out. We'll have Station 1 off of 23 between Mount and Van Dyke. But then our four outlying stations will be out, pushed out towards the corners of the township. and where the residents are, because that's where we want to be. We want our stations located in the residential areas, and with the development coming in the next couple of years in the northeast sections 1 and 2, this will balance our loading, put the fire station into the residential areas as opposed to being in the commercial and industrial area where it currently is.
Has construction started on that yet, or?
We've been moving slowly. We just got some preliminary stuff done. We had some issues with the road commission, with the right-of-way and the drains, and we had a lot of things to deal with in the fall. So we've been working through it slowly with that, but you know, it just the way things happened.
With recreation on the water being kind of a big fad going on now, and you guys having the Swift Water Rescue and having to deal with the Clinton River, what might be some of the plans coming up this year that how you guys will deal with that, or is the Clinton River's got to be a focal point, I guess, for the fire department?
Oh, it is, and year by year we're getting more and more, and I believe our last numbers I saw, there was close to 9,000 boats that went down to Clinton River last year. And that's a lot of recreational activity, and we're getting called more and more down to the river. Problem is, we don't have a lot of access. And when we, in the areas we do have access, we don't have any way to get the equipment down except carrying it by hand. So we have been, through the fall, we've been looking at getting a gator, a four-wheel drive gator that we have, you know, where we can put a backboard and strap a patient on there, have an attendant, and get our equipment down there, because right now, in some of the areas that we get to, we are carrying stuff down there. And working with the Parks and Rec Department, we have been targeting some areas to get some trails cut so we can get down to the river. And so we're gonna be working, you know, continuing the progress from the last couple of years on that, but we're really gonna start, you know, trying to get, you know, now that the trail has been completed, that they put up there, it gives us a little bit more access. So we're gonna be working with that and trying just to, you know, enhance the services that we already have for the river.
And if I could point out too, I believe with your department, and I don't know if it was Parks and Rec or maybe even some grants, now parts of the river are marked, so if you are lost or you tip or something's happening, now you have a way, you don't say, I'm in the middle of trees, come rescue me. You can give a number and you guys can locate them through these numbers on the signs.
Yeah, that was a really good idea that Firefighter Rebecca had several years ago. Is similar to like trails and like even the freeways that have marker posts. He actually developed a marking system for the river. And we have continued that down through Utica into Sterling. We're going west and trying to get Rochester Hills and other areas west of us, and also try to get this all the way down towards Clinton Township and Mount Clemens to continue his marking system all the way down the river. Macomb County GIS department has been working with us, so this is going to be in the digital maps that, you know, you find up there. It'll be a regular point on there, so we've been working with them. They've been very helpful working with Jeremy over the last couple of years trying to get this to where it needs to be. But yeah, there's marker signs up and down the river in our area, and we're also going east and west with it as well.
Okay. Chief, in closing, I guess if you could inform the residents on what maybe they can expect from you guys this year, if there's any big changes or anything.
Well, I mean, the biggest thing is we always like to push, and we're also making another effort with fire prevention, training our residents, getting, you know, obviously if you can prevent emergencies from happening, that obviously is a lot better for them. So we've been working with the factories. We have some new simulators. We got a grant from last year with about how to use proper fire extinguishers, that it's hands-on, so we've been trying to get this out. We'll be including that in our public relations events that we do, just to try and get training and education out to the residents, and that's always been the top of our platform, is proper education, and you know, and that is what we are trying to push, transparency. And you know, the biggest thing that we like to do is to make the best use of the taxpayers' dollars that we have, and make sure what we're investing, because anytime we spend money, I know there's a lot of talk on it of that it's wasteful, it's this, but we look at it, and especially I look at it, is not that I'm spending money, but we're investing the taxpayers' money back into the resources for them, for their needs, should there be a need to call. That is, you know, what drives what we buy and when we buy the equipment, and hire the personnel, is it's an investment back into the residents that are here all the time.
Hello everyone, we are continuing our 2017 look ahead, or 2018 look ahead I should say, and look back at 2017. And we're lucky enough to have in the studio with me here, Mark Hackle, he's the Macomb County Executive, and Shelby Township Supervisor, Richard Stathicus. Thank you both for being here.
Well, thank you for having me.
Thanks, enjoy it.
You guys, it's been a pretty busy year, 2017, for Shelby, not only the county. And I'd like to start off with, what were some of the major accomplishments that happened here for the township in 2017?
Well, as you know, our Shelby Manor apartment building, 264 units, was sold, and it was about a six-month process. And my hat's off to our treasurer, Mr. Michael Flynn, did a fabulous job with that process, along with Rob Huth. But we were able to actually drop a check of almost $15 million into our account a couple days ago because of that. So we're really happy about that. And a great thing about that is that we're able to not just take care of 264 people now, we can take that money, pay down our legacy costs, and that's what we did. We transferred $5 million into that account. And also, we've got now $10 million for a new library and senior center. So we're pretty excited. And then of course, Mark, you know, the Amazon building, that was a
incredible.
great deal for Shelby Township. A number one commerce business in the world right here in our Shelby Township backyard.
And probably one of the biggest business attraction deals this county has ever seen.
Yeah.
I don't remember another project that really came together as well as it did in a short period of time when Amazon was looking at that site. I knew everybody had to be hush-hush and there was the gag orders that were kind of put on us, if you will. But boy, I tell you what, working with the township, the MEDC, those national renowned developers, and obviously the planning department, you talk about putting something together and putting an incredible package together, and even having to go to Lansing for that final piece, dealing with, you know, the remediation of that brownfield. Boy, $10 million to clean up that site, and we were able to make that happen so they can go ahead and establish a million square foot facility, bringing 1,000 jobs to Macomb County, but in particular Shelby Township. Great job.
And we're really happy, and thank you for your leadership. This would not have been done without your office. We really want to thank you for all your help and cooperation getting this done for Shelby Township. We're really happy.
And Shelby's pretty much kind of taken the lead. I mean, I get to deal with the county, you know, all different aspects of it, but when we look at Shelby Township, working with their planning department, trying to look at for that development and opportunities, boy, what's happening at Cherry Creek with the developments that are taking place over there and the industrial facilities, the investment in Macomb County, you know, the story to be told is actually in Shelby Township. It's an incredible story, but with that, countywide, I mean, we may be living in the best of times Macomb County has ever seen when you stop and look at, you know, the population growth, the household income levels that have grown up, people even with their educational attainment levels, everything is just taking off and people are moving here. 12 people a day since 2010 have made Macomb their home. That's 12 people a day on average. Wow. Boy, that's a statement, and they don't just come there because, you know, people are telling them to come here. They feel welcome and they feel like there's job opportunities, great educational systems that we have, quality of life opportunities. So really this is a good story that we have to tell here in Macomb County. Unfortunately, I get to do a lot of that.
Now, gentlemen, a big part of getting companies like Amazon into our county and our township or smaller areas is through some tax incentives and things like that. What are your thoughts on offering a major corporation tax incentives and why would it benefit the township to do so?
Well, you know, many people think we're not collecting any tax revenue for the next 10 or 20 years, but that's not true. We're actually, UCS will be getting 59% of the total tax base in the next 10 to 20 years. So every year they'll be getting tax revenue, and that's a good thing. So when you look at, you know, leaving the land as it was, which means that we were collecting a few thousand dollars worth, or taking what we have now, oh my word, I mean, there's no comparison. We've collected over $600,000 in fees alone in about 4 or 5 months. And also, like I said, the UCS will be getting their tax money, and it's just good for everybody. As Mark mentioned, we're going to probably bring almost 1,200 jobs to Shelby Township, as well as another 100 managerial jobs. Good jobs, paying about $60,000 a year for the managers and about $30,000 for the workers, and that's including benefits. So it's really good for Shelby Township.
And as far as the incentive part of it, I think our involvement in it is to work with Lansing, the MEDC, when they start talking about, you know, funding that might be available to kind of put towards these projects that the state has. And we've been able to do that, very fortunate, with the Economic Development Corporation. We did bring substantial amount of money, about $4.5 million, into this project as a result of it. But I think more importantly than that, and you know, fixing some of the roads and trying to accommodate the traffic that might be there, people get concerned about it. Stop and think about it. That site over there for years has been a concern, has been a problem. And it's a not only just a brownfield, but there's an environmental hazard there that needed to be cleaned up. Nobody was coming forth with the money to make that happen. And because of this project, because of Amazon talking about wanting to locate here, that was not a concern to them because they realized that will happen. $10 million is being invested, as I mentioned earlier, to clean up that site. That is absolutely incredible because before that building is even built, we now have remediated a problem that probably could have been a legacy for Shelby Township for years to come. Look at that site that the Jimmy John's field is on over there in Utica. That baseball, that field, before they threw out the first pitch, it was a home run because we remediated a problem that was leaching into the actual Clinton River. And that was a landfill. But now you've got an economic development, quality of life asset right here near Shelby Township. That's pretty much as much of an asset to Shelby that it is to Utica. But this is an incredible asset to the county, and we no longer have to worry about an environmental hazard in Shelby Township that once was.
No, you're exactly right. They're actually digging as deep as 20 to 30 feet in the ground, removing some of the cement foundations. We had leaky gas pipes. All those are removed. And it's just really been good for Shelby Township. I've always been worried, what are we going to use that land for? Who's going to have $10 million to put that kind of money up front? It's just really hard to come by. So it's really good for Shelby Township. We're excited.
And these business attractions that we're talking about, I'm telling you, Shelby Township's gotten a reputation, and so has the county to some extent, where it's no longer that difficult for us to actually have to go out and market ourselves or to get them to come here. Word is out, you know, that we're open for business, and business is coming here. There are plenty of jobs available right now for people that are interested in obtaining a job. I mean, 1,000 jobs from one facility over there by 23 Mile Road in Mound. Boy, you pair that up with what's going on in that industrial complex and other
Shelby
areas throughout the county.
Yeah. 1,200 new jobs just in Shelby's Parkway. And that to Amazon, we're up to about 2,200 jobs in the next 12 months. That's awesome.
Well, with that, those added jobs, something you mentioned earlier were roads. Infrastructure obviously has to be taken care of, whether a local level or a national level. Shelby, here in Shelby Township, you've always been good about roads. Tell us a little bit about how your thought process on roads and why they're so important, obviously, you know, besides driving, what to a reputation of a township.
Well, you know, I know we always say that good financial planning is a cornerstone of a solid community, but you know, you got to have good roads too. Without roads, you don't have commerce. That's why we've been putting over $1 million a year into roads since Mike Flynn and Mr. Wozniak and I have been elected. And we're going to continue doing that together with our partnership that we have with the county and the federal government. You're good at getting that federal aid that we need. We've actually been able to invest about $50 million worth of real tax dollars into our roads right here in Shelby Township. And even though they are the best roads, they're not still good enough. We've got some big projects on the schedule right now, and we're looking forward to, you know, repaving 21 Mile Road. And also we're looking at expanding 23 Mile Road as well. But that's all, you know, hopefully the 23 Mile will not work, or it's not 23 Mile, I'm sorry, Chainer between 23 and 26 Mile. Mm-hmm. That'll probably happen sometime in 2019 or 2020. But 21 Mile Road, we're looking forward to that happening actually this year. And we're, you know, pretty happy with Hall Road too. That was done with, in about 8 or 9 months, just as scheduled.
Yeah, and MDOT did a wonderful job with that. I got to give them credit. Probably the two major projects that MDOT had was the 33 Mile Road, obviously trying to get an off-ramp and on-ramp back on there for their industrial opportunities, and then what just happened with M59. They're going to be continuing work on that starting in April on the other section, but the part that, you know, connected with Shelby Township, boy, they did an outstanding job, MDOT did, of keeping traffic flowing, keeping people informed, and making sure that the business owners in and around there understood what was going on. I applaud them, and I even called Kurt Steidel as a result of that to tell him there was a major change to that road. It wasn't just a, you know, redoing a road, it was a redevelopment of that road. And with that being said, that'll always be the challenge, funding to deal with our infrastructure. 15 Mile Road, obviously the Utica Clinton Township concerned with that underground sewer issue that we had there. Candace Miller, the partnership we have with her now, I can't say enough about that, because roads and bridges are not just the infrastructure that we're concerned about anymore. It's what we don't see that we're concerned about as well. And the funding isn't there. We get that. The question has to be, okay, you know, how do we do more with what we have? It's always, you know, you kind of get from those that want to provide the funding, you're going to have to do more with less. Well, we're trying to figure out, how do we do more with what we have? That becomes the bigger challenge, and we're trying to be creative with the funding, you know, where we do a match, you know, with the township on some of these projects. But it'll always be a concern until the true amount of funding that is necessary comes our way to really help, you know, sustain the problem that we're seeing with infrastructure right now.
And sticking with that, obviously, collapsed water mains are something that you didn't plan for, but you had to work with townships and municipalities across Macomb. Tell me a little bit how it was to deal with that, and obviously Mrs. Miller headed that up.
I don't think there's any question about it. Candace Miller did an outstanding job on this project from day one, and I say that for this reason. I don't know if we've had as much media attention, transparency, and bidding of projects and awarded. And I say that because this is very important. People need to understand that when you're bidding projects, you're trying to get the biggest bang for your buck, and the biggest bang for the buck is the ratepayers that are paying for these things. And that was never done before. That was not happening out of that office. That is happening now, and she was extremely transparent. She had more press conferences, I think, than her predecessor had in 24 years during that 1 year period. But why do you do that? Because you want people to have information. Information is knowledge, information is power, and she gave that right to those business owners, right to those homeowners, and quite honestly, the commuters that were driving in and around that area. So the media ate it up, they were there, they were listening, they were paying attention. Any issues they may have had were a concern that took place, but you know what, nothing got into our rivers and our lakes while she was there as well. She was very much on top of that. I'm glad because our partnership isn't just about trying to work on what's going on with the underground. Our Department of Roads is now working closely, side by side with Public Works. That's never happened before. And our Planning and Economic Development Department is working with them as well, because roads and infrastructure are a huge attraction piece for corporations and businesses to want to come to this area.
And one thing I want to add to that too, Candace Miller has been really good to Shelby Township and other townships around here too, as far as cleaning out our ditches and what have you. And you know, nobody in 8 years has actually approached us. And we were actually thinking about putting that out for bid, and she called and asked us what we needed. We told her, and she's got three of the six ditches pretty well cleaned out, the drain ditches. So we're real happy about that. And probably sometime in January, that'll all be behind us. So we really appreciate the great job and partnership that we have with Candace's office as well.
I know we're getting close to the end here, but I got to tell you, that drain thing, I'm trying to get away from that terminology, because those drains that we're looking at nowadays, those are natural flowing waterways. And, you know, they become clean access. The drains that I'm concerned about are the ones underwater that are, you know, the sewage issue. But we're trying to focus on a drain trails project to start working on getting people closer and better connected with those drains, if you will. I even hate calling them drains. I'd rather call them creeks, but we do. We call them drains because they are.
2 months ago, they looked so very natural.
Well,
yes.
Well, General, we're coming to the close here. Something you're looking forward to in 2018 that excites you here in the township?
Well, you know, we got a lot of projects going on. We're expanding the police station. We're going to go from about 18,000 square feet to 25,000 square feet. That'll be done sometime next year. A brand new court, we've been working on that for, 17 years? That's going to be done sometime next year. Another new fire station going up, that'll be done sometime next year as well. So that'll be two new fire stations in about a 15-month period. And the good thing about it, we're paying cash for everything. Taxes will not go up one penny. And the last thing I want to mention is a senior center and also the library. That's going to be started sometime next year. It'll be completed in 2020. A lot going on in Shelby Township.
Gentlemen, I hate that we have to close. We're out of time now. I appreciate you being on, and good luck in this new year with all
Thank
your
you.
Endeavors.
Thank you, Art.
For the county and the township.
Hey, thanks
appreciate
for a great
it.
Partnership.
Thank
we appreciate
you. Anytime.
It.
Anytime. You bet. Art, okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for having
nice
us.
Thanks, Art.
You bet.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you for joining us for our special Look Ahead episode. We're excited to see all the great things happening in Shelby Township as well as Macomb County during the new year. If you missed any part of these interviews, check us out online or on Facebook by searching Shelby TV. Be sure to stay with us at Shelby This Week all throughout 2018 as we will bring you the latest news and information from around the community. Happy New Year, and thanks for watching.